Hey everyone, it's me. Finally got some new clothes. I haven't hardly gotten any clothes since around September the 11th, and I'm not even kidding. I've gotten t-shirts, but that's about it. My wife bought me some clothes. So, anyway, I'm loving the fall weather. It's a breath of fresh air to be sure. I might actually try to get a tripod and do some shooting videos. I've never made a quality shooting video or a quality iPhone camera shooting video. So that's something I'd like to do since I'm a one-man operation. I have a bunch of animals and all running in the background if you're hearing snorting noises, cage rattling, and bells and stuff, by the way. I love that MP5 I got. That thing is badass. I need to go shoot it, but I mean, I would recommend it. Side by side next to a fully automatic real HK MP5, there's literally no differences, no visible differences other than the logos or whatever they engraved in. That's originally what I wanted even before I got an AR-15. That was my first prepper gun, was an AR-15, because this is my first rifle, I should say. And I got the AR-15 because I was in the Army and I wanted to be more and more proficient as I could with the damn rifle I would use a lot, you know, when I deployed. So I didn't like the 16-inch barrel version when I was using usually the 14.5-inch barrel version. I could tell a difference in the handling. But anyway, I got rid of it to get an OPAP. And so if you're on the fence about getting one of those MP5s, I would get one. And I'm so glad I got one. But years ago when I got the AR-15, I wanted the MP5, and then I looked up how much the MP5s were, and they were ridiculous. The reason why I'd recommend an MP5 is because shooting indoors, even with hearing protection on and crap, and I've done a lot of that, the sound is just horrible. Or even if someone's standing up with a M4 and you're laying down on the ground or trying to shoot around something with hearing protection on, the sound is absolutely insane. And so the MP5 is the best submachine gun ever made, pretty much. No one can, all these new blowback designs still, on full auto, the MP5 can stay on target, unlike about any other weapon in the world. But the noise and concussion, and it actually has better penetration than 5.56. And even at 300 yards, I think you're still having bullets going like 800 feet per second or something like that. It might not have the velocity, but it has the mass. But and they have better range than people think. What gets me is with James Yeager. He'll sit there and endorse 22 long rifle and take an M&P 15 22 AR-15 through a tactical response class, and yet he'll tell people to stop buying pistol caliber carbines, which are pretty much semi-automatic versions of submachine guns. He'll tell people to stop buying them, but the 9mm has better penetration and really better ballistics, I think, than from what I've read. I'm no ballistics guy, but it looks a lot better on paper than the 22 long rifle. So I've always wanted one. I'm thinking about maybe getting the MP5K version from Zenith or the Scorpion Evo. I've seen some really cool versions. One is on Travis Haley's channel. There's one with like a retractable HK style slider stock, and then he also has a silencer on it. It really looked nice. There's also like carbine kits, like super short barrels, like the MP5 Kurtz or whatever, the short PDW MP5. There's some really cool stuff you can do with the MP5, and they have a lot of the controls like an MP5 as well, and some AR-15 traits. So I'm considering getting one, but the price on a lot of the H&K roller delayed blowback stuff is really, let me see if I'm still recording, yes. The prices on a lot of the HK classic roller delayed blowback crap is really gone down. There's a lot of shit that they had a hard time getting into the country years ago that are a decent price now. Just looking like around 2013, a lot of the the stuff I take for granted now, I notice people couldn't find, or it was outrageously expensive. And a lot of the extra parts and everything for G3s or Setme or HK91 style rifles, which I have and love, and MP5 crap, and then the HK556 are pretty affordable now. So, and Zenith opened up a new plant, or not plant, a factory, and is focusing on the roller delayed blowback stuff from Turkey. And the quality is pretty cool. It's almost like an Arsenal AK, you know, maybe that nice black, crazy military style finish and just craftsmanship you would never expect out of the United States with stamped sheet metal and shit like that. I'm petting my dog. So, if HK makes a 308, or if Zenith makes a 308, I think it's called the Z41, I'll get that. And I wouldn't mind getting the, their 556 model. I'm not a big 556 guy, but that Z41 looks badass. I saw a picture of one with an ACOG and a, this is a 556 model based on the H&K 33, KA3, I believe. It has a 13-inch barrel. The Zenith version is called the Z43P, I believe. But with a retractable stock and an ACOG, that thing looks nasty. So I wouldn't mind having it. That way I could have a 5.56 that everyone tries to bitch at me about not having. I would have a 5.56 rifle that's not a goddamn AR-15. Everyone has an AR-15 now, and I guess I want to be different. I'm not a fan of the direct gas impingement design, but I mean, I think it's the crappiest military style rifle ever made. But I will say, when the P-MAG was introduced, it really made the AR-15s or M16 series of rifles a lot more reliable. So anyway, I'm rambling on. Thanks for watching and take care.